Mr. Andrew Selous.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, and I beg to move that leave be given to bring a bill to make provision about periodical local authority reviews of the housing needs of gypsy and traveller communities, to make provision for the conversion of caravan sites into settled accommodation, to require local authorities to provide temporary caravan stopping sites where there is a demonstrated need, and to create a criminal offence of unauthorised encampment, to make provision about the education of gypsy and traveller children, to require schools to have regard to gypsy and traveller culture and heritage in teaching, and for connected purposes. Mr. Speaker, I am presenting this motion to Parliament today because current traveller law, created with the best of intentions since the Caravan Sites Act 1968, is not working. My local authority has 40 traveller sites. Settled residents of the area, travellers themselves, and especially their children, and many others who live on traveller sites, have all had terrible experiences in recent years. The current policy of segregation has resulted in a failure of integration and very poor community cohesion. Mr. Speaker, we are sent to this place to represent all of our constituents, whatever their identity. I will set out the recent experiences of settled residents, travellers, and that of a number of tenants living on traveller sites. I want the very best outcomes for every one of those groups, and I'm convinced that the current legal framework which we make local authorities work under has completely failed. A growing number of settled residents have written to me recently to say that they are now moving out of my area because they no longer feel safe, because they've been repeated victims of crime, including physical assault, theft from their home and from vehicles, especially vans, and trespass around the home. Others said to BBC reporters following the third adjournment debate I've held on this issue in September this year, that they wanted to leave the area because of these problems, but were not able to do so. This is a disgraceful state of affairs that should shame us all, and it should be a wake-up call to the government to take action. Yeah. Shopkeepers, businesses, pubs, as well as individuals and families, are regularly raising these concerns with me. Yep. Many local farmers and rural businesses live in constant fear, but that fear is also experienced by many people in neighbouring towns as well. Traveller ponies are often let loose over other people's property, and levels of fly tipping are extremely high. Now, Mr. Speaker, I would not claim for one moment that these types of crimes are committed by one section of the community alone. Of course not. And there is good and bad in every group across the whole of our society. But I would not be being honest if I did not point out the considerable amount of police activity expended in relation to traveller sites, a number of which are in effect ungoverned space where it is difficult to enforce the rule of law. When I look at the standard of accommodation that many travellers and their children are living in, I am truly shocked. In a large number of traveller sites, there is no proper sewage system, with human excrement flowing into local ditches. Some sites don't even have proper water supplies, and in some cases, neighbouring settled residents have lost their supply of water when it has been illegally tapped into. I have raised these issues repeatedly with the Environment Agency, who tell me that they struggle to deal with these issues. It is also a disgrace that we tolerate this type of deplorable accommodation in one of the wealthiest countries in the world. We also know from the Prime Minister's race disparity audit that traveller children have the worst educational outcomes of any group in our society. I was so concerned about this that I asked the Children's Commissioner for England to visit one of my local schools which many traveller children attend. And the Commissioner wrote back to me after her visit to say that some children were not in school at all during the summer term travelling season, which is when children do exams, which open up their life chances to all the opportunities they should have available to them. The Commissioner also said that most of the travellers talked about children leaving school when they were 14 to 16 years old, and their educational outcomes bear witness to the fact that the home education they may or may not be provided with is not leading to good outcomes for their children. And education inclusion officers, and I have some of the best, struggle to get children into school, and there are also concerns about child welfare. There's also a third group we should remember, and that is those sublet to on these sites. Many have come to me reporting intimidation, violence, summary rent increases, failure to provide tenancy agreements or return deposits. There's also been not one but three incidents of modern slavery requiring massive police resource on one of my sites. So in order to deal with these issues, part one of the bill would seek a unified planning system by amending the current periodical local authority reviews, which force councils to provide separate traveller sites. Local authorities would have a duty to provide enough settled accommodation for everyone, travellers and settled residents. 76% of travellers already live in settled accommodation anyway, and I have many positive examples of parents joining formal work, children attending school regularly when travellers have moved into settled accommodation in my constituency. And this would end the current policy of segregation, which pits community against community and leads to terrible outcomes for both settled residents and travellers themselves. Part one of the bill would also end the current situation where local authorities who have some traveller sites are then told by the planning inspectorate to build more and more sites on a multiplier effect. My authority has 40 sites already, the vast majority being privately run ones with very little control over them, whereas other local authorities have no sites at all, and this is fundamentally unfair. Part two would allow conversion of current traveller sites to settled accommodation to allow greater integration on current sites. Part three, having removed the requirement of local authorities to authorise permanent traveller sites, would require local authorities, where there was a demonstrable need, to follow the successful policy of Sandwell Council in having temporary stopping sites for which a deposit and rent would be paid. These sites would facilitate travellers being able to travel. Part four would make unauthorised encampments a criminal offence, as in Ireland, a country that is also subject to the European Convention on Human Rights. Part five would ensure that schools have regard to the underachievement of traveller children, given that the race disparity audit has shown that traveller children have such bad educational outcomes. And in the same way we teach Black History Month in some of our schools, Gypsy culture and heritage will be taught as well. So overall, the bill therefore ends the current failed segregation policy, which causes so much misery to the communities affected. It allows existing sites to become properly integrated into current communities, and allows travellers to travel on properly authorised and regulated sites and take steps to deal with the huge levels of illiteracy and underachievement of traveller children. It's a balanced, humane package which would end the misery that so many settled communities endure at the moment and deliver better outcomes for travellers themselves. At the moment, the government is examining the submissions to its consultation on unauthorised encampments. While this is a significant issue that absolutely needs to be addressed, it is only one part of a much wider issue which the government needs to undertake a complete review of. For too long, the government has ignored the mounting evidence of the failure of its current policies. All I see is misery, criminality, mounting frustration, and real anger at those in authority. As other members have pointed out in previous debates, there's not much point in getting elected to Parliament if it's not possible to do anything about these issues. Yeah. Current policy contributes to the undermining of our democracy. I know that inertia bias or the tyranny of the status quo is a significant influence over governments of every composition. We are elected, however, to bring about policies that are truly compassionate, genuinely work for all in our society, and are based on the evidence of what is happening in our constituencies. I beg to move.
Yeah.
Thank you. The question is that the Honourable Gentleman have leave to bring in the bill. As many as are of that opinion say aye.
Aye.
On the contrary, no. I think the ayes have it. Who will prepare and bring in the bill?
Sir David Amos, Tim Lawton, Steve Double, John Speller, Priti Patel, Victoria Prentice, Mark Francois, Mark Pawsey, Sir Robert Sims, Ruth George, and Jim Shannon, and myself, sir.
Yeah.
Andrew Selous.
Gypsy and Traveller Communities Housing Planning and Education Bill.
Second reading what day?
Friday, 23rd November.
Friday, the 23rd of November. Thank you. Order, we now come to...